ये लगता है कि डोमिनेंट फॉर्म होने की वजह से ख्याल बिकेम यू नो फिजिकली मोर अट्रैक्टिव देन ध्रुपद एंड ध्रुपद हैड दैट जेनेटिक प्लान एज आई से पहले नोमतोम में आलापचारि हो गई अब पखावज के साथ आपको गाना है पखावज में खेगा होता ही नहीं उसकी लैंग्वेज ही ऐसी बनी हुई बाय द टाइम केम टू जो कंबाइन हुई ध्रुपद वो तो अपना तरीका नहीं बदल रहा तो उसके साथ गाने तो क्या करेंगे आप सो दैट मीन्स यू टू मूव इन स्टेप टू स्टेप और इट्स वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग दैट बोथ दीज इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स एंड बोथ दीज कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ ध्रुपद मेकिंग दे आर क्लोजली टाइड अप विद ईच अदर एंड देयर आर टर्म्स टू सजेस्ट कि ताल परण एंड सुर परण ने जैसा परण वहां बजाएगा वैसे गाने वाला भी गाएगा ये कभी नहीं हुआ आजकल जो हो रहा है वो उल्टा हो रहा है सिर्फ यानी मैं गाता हूँ फिर उसको कहता हूँ कि तुम मेरी नकल करो उल्टा कभी नहीं हुआ ये भी पहले होता था दैट सजेस्टिव इट वॉज अ वेरी प्री कंपोज एंड दैट मीन्स इट वॉज क्लूजली टाइड एंड दैट मीन्स यू नो आई मीन अगर आपने आलापी अच्छी की तो बाद में आप क्या करोगे क्या और ठुमड़ी जैसा तो उसमें नहीं करेंगे कि अर्थ लेके कुछ कर रहे वो भी नहीं होगा तो करोगे क्या एंड आई थिंक दैट वॉज ए एस्थेटिकली डेड द ध्रुपद कुडंट हैव डन एनीथिंग एल्स एंड द मोमेंट एज आई सेड यू नो चाली आज वेर वेरी इन अ वे वेरी क्लेवर एसिमिलेटिव फॉर्म वो डोमिनेंट फॉर्म था तो उन्होंने ध्रुपद के जो अच्छे एलिमेंट्स थे वो लेना शुरू किया इसलिए वो सादरा बना इसलिए लंगड़ा ध्रुपद बना ये बीच बीच में ध्रुपद है वो बीच बीच में नहीं है ऐसा जो होता है वो लंगड़ा ध्रुपद अब जैसे ये है जाने आकल सब आप भयो है अपनी कहत और काबू की ना माने हर गल सब ये तो ध्रुपद जैसा चला ऐसे बहुत देखे डर समान सहन या पीती पर गुणगन की विद्या निकृष्ट बखाने अकल सौजा
जयपुर रत्नावली अलग
लंगड़ा ध्रुपद है ना
अलग
अब ये जो चल रहा है जन ये चालिया वेयर इनकॉर्पोरेटिंग एलिमेंट्स फ्रॉम ध्रुपद एज दे विश एंड एक्सप्लॉइटिंग इट अब इसमें मैं तान भी ले सकता हूँ इसमें बोलतान भी ले सकता हूँ कुछ भी कर सकता हूँ उसमें
सो दे वर यूजिंग द फेमिलियरिटी ऑफ द प्रेडिसेसर सॉन्ग टू ड्रॉ आउट ऑडियंसेस
डोंट से प्रेडिसेसर contemporary form, yes, which was accentuating certain anibaddha elements. Now, Khyalia said, for being anibaddha, we would like to have something nibaddha. So, prema was Khyalia was there. And that made it different. You know, Drupad, again, you know, I feel that's very interesting that Surbahar aage nahi badhega, kyunki Sitar ne Surbahar ka kaam utha diya hai. देर इज समथिंग लाइक सर्वाइवल ऑफ द फिटेस्ट अगर एक ही इंस्ट्रूमेंट में दोनों बातें मुझे मिल रही है तो वाई डू यू नीड अनदर इंस्ट्रूमेंट तो चले गए नहीं वैसे ख्याल किया और मुझे ये भी लग रहा है कि आजकल ठुमरी वो कर रही है ख्याल को यानी एक्सपांसिव बन रही है ठुमरी
नॉट इन गुड म्यूजिशियन
हाँ बट यू नो आई मीन हैव दैट पोटेंशियल आप जो ठुमरी बन रही है अब डज मीन डीज टेन ईयर्स यू नो आई मीन यू सी दैट इफ यू गो बाय द एविडेंस अवेलेबल सभी रागों में ठुमरी है हू सेड दैट ठुमरी लाइट रागों में गाई जाती है तो सारे छोटे ख्याल जो आज भाखंडे साहब ने लिखे और लोगों ने गाना शुरू किया इतने सारे वो छोटे ख्याल बननी शुरू नहीं आती But that is one of the bone of contention, that is, you know, you have killed off the Bandishki Tundri by introducing a child in that, to that extent. So, mujhe ye lagta hai, ki, you know, I mean, why khayal became dominant form? Because it had these four characteristics I mentioned earlier. And this is a flux situation always, as far as genres are concerned. And that, you know, that leads us to the next point, the aesthetic appraisal. And I feel that, again here, the same logic applies, that if Khayal is able to do what Drupad had been doing, in addition to what it itself can do, then naturally it is more satisfying. And Drupad, at that form of its Nibadha phase, had distinguished musical elements to such an extent that they had become segregated elements. They were not only separate, but they have become segregated altogether.
Isolated.
Ah, bilkul. They were not linked to it. They only used to follow each other. They were not linked.
It's a bajarab.
And that's why I think that is one reason. Then naturally, I think somewhere along the line, Drupad ka bhi many-sided jo personality thi, usko hum log cut karte hain. Now I would like to refer to the texture, the content part of it. I don't know how, but people started saying that Drupad has only certain themes. But if you really study text of the Drupads, I don't feel that it is a statement which is warranted in this way. Drupad has dealt with a number of things which we are not familiar with. And obviously, it reflects a certain kind of audience and a level of audience. For example, I would mention a very interesting case. This is corroborated, this has been mentioned very clearly in Sahasras. Nayab Bakshu, whose collection Sahasras contains, has been said to be superior to Tansen for some particular reasons. What are those reasons? Firstly, he never used to have any vocal accompaniment. Secondly, he used to play rhythm instrument accompaniment himself by the singing. Thirdly, he used to sing in a very high pitch. These have been specific features mentioned about Bakshu which made him superior to Tansen. Now, if you analyze the textual content of Sahasra's composition, you will be amazed to see that there are esoteric themes as well as general themes. My contention is that if Bakshu could retain his popularity 100 years after his death, that the Badshah had to ask somebody to make a collection of his songs because they were so, even when he has departed from the scene, and if these thematically contain material which is so esoteric, that means, number one, the listeners were conversant with the medium and the content. And that's why the composed music element again comes to the fore. That you knew the theme, even though it was esoteric, it was known to you because you are of a certain knowledgeable standard. So if I talk to my audiences in Drupad about raga and intricacies of raga and tala, that naturally means that the audience is appreciating enough of this thematic material. Now this language. And we are now talking of Drupads which are either in praise of God
or the Maharaja.
At the best, you describe seasons. That's all. and you analyze the compositions, apart from, you know, Naika Bhed and all those, all kinds of themes have been touched upon in this. And this, I think, later on vanished from the scene, for whatever the, I mean, there are reasons, but the reasons, whatever they are, thematically, Drupad area was becoming smaller and smaller. At the same time, you see Thumri and Ghazal and Khayal, they were moving ahead. They are conquering new territories, whether it was thematic or not. As I refer to Nawab's compositions, he is taking themes from folk music and turning them into khayals. And he is using khayal tals and khayal rags. This is very interesting.
So poetry, which was the mainstay of Drupad, itself started getting weaker, and therefore the logic for Drupad started getting weaker.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, on what ground you can say that this is a form which you cannot do without? If other forms start giving you the same thing, then you are on a losing ground.
And you start losing that
feel. Yes. Then perhaps, you know, one can also reckon with another argument here. Actually, when Sadaranga, Adaranga and Kawal, Bacche Ka Gharana and all the history which we have familiar with, suggests to you one more thing again. And that is that the individual is coming to the fore. To say that Bhakshu was great because he didn't have vocal accompaniment also suggests that usually Drupad was made with vocal accompaniment and it was not as solo as Khayal used to be. It's very interesting tradition that quite a few Drupad singers sing in pairs.
Even today.
But you don't come across Khayal singers singing in pairs.
What do you ascribe this necessity to? Is it stamina problem or is it just holding interest from
you? No, very positive aspect of individual asking for more freedom. If two people are singing together, I am operating under constraint. And Khayal meant, no, I want to have freedom. This is real music solo. One person making music. And that, you know, you would also see that very interestingly, in Drupad singing, the Pakhawas player had a major share. In Khayal, no. You wanted a tabla accompanist. You wanted a drone. And all your string instruments will follow you. They will not make music with you. They will follow you. All this suggests that Khayal was meant for an individual and the aspiration to give more scope to one single individual music maker contributed a great deal. It's also perhaps, you know, interesting that when the Britishers came here, in all other areas of life, people have been saying that you liberated individuals to what? More individualistic spirit. Whether it was literature, poetry, drama, what was happening? This was happening. This is what reflected.
Okay. So what you are saying, you mostly describe the golden age of Khayal, the first half of the 20th century, was probably also a gift of the British Empire too?
No. I am saying that it is also a manifestation of a general pervasive tendency of the individuals to assert themselves as individuals.
Helped along by Macaulay.
Helped along by many people. I mean, I feel, you know, sometimes I feel that Macaulay is not the cause, he is the result. If the whole psyche of a nation moves towards a particular point, somebody becomes an excuse or responsible for manifesting the tendency. But he is not the cause of it. The cause is us. He is only a symbol. He becomes a symbol if he is powerful enough. Otherwise, he becomes a sign. come to who likes what kind of music. Now, audience for Drupad was elite audience, sophisticated audience, knowledgeable audience. Audience for Khayal was perhaps not initiated audience, but it liked music, a lover of music, yes, and perhaps, you know, more heterogeneous audience. And the moment you talk of heterogeneous audience, it also means that it comes with more kinds of expectations to music making of audience.
More diverse.
Wider spectrum of expectations. And one of the expectations would be that not only the intellectual pleasure of it, but emotional satisfaction. And I feel that Khayal began giving that emotional satisfaction. And that's why, you know, Khayal also scored a point with that. Again, very interestingly, till the Britishers came on the scene, we never talked of importance of emotional manifestation in literature. And you will see that Rabindranath, in one place, he complains about Indian music. He says, this Indian music, I want to sing of my own sorrow. The moment I break into Indian music, he starts singing of universal sorrow. Where is the place for my sorrow? I want to sing for my sorrow, my happiness, not universal happiness. So he says that if I want to sing about my own losses, and if I am compelled to sing, say, Todi or Multani, it becomes a universal sorrow. There is no place for individuals there. In one place he says that that's why I want to compose music, I want to write poetry, I want to sing. Individual asserting himself to the fullest. So popularity, yes, popularity in the sense that people like Khayal more because it fulfilled or it responded to many more needs than the group. And Igor Stravinsky one place says that there are certain musical needs of every society. So we are not talking here of social needs or sociological cravings, we are talking of musical needs. At one point of time one thinks, no, music must express emotions, music must express moods, music must express intellectual elements. And that's the cultural need. Now people wanted to have emotional needs satisfied through music. What kind of music was available to them? Either it was religious music, which again did not allow individuals to sing of their own emotions, it was a collective emotion. Or folk music, which again did the same thing, collectivity. And the moment you have industrialization processes coming in, this is being attacked. Secondly, you have popular music coming into, and you will see very interestingly that all the regions in India which gave birth to popular forms of music after the Britishers came here, after the 17th century to be precise, all of them were more emotional and all of them were more outgoing to the extent that they became obscene because they wanted to liberate themselves. See the Thumris, see the Tamasha Lavnis, and you will see that even in Bengal we had this
Jatra.
Yes. And Nidhu Babu being accused of being obscene. Tappa was considered obscene. One of the Sharad Chandra's characters says, oh, all the women are sitting, aur wo aati hai. So usko kehte hai ki aap sab hami baithe hai. You know, with that kind of titillation, ki hami baithe to aap tappa rao. What does it indicate? I mean, tappa, if you read the text of Nidhu Babu's tappa, none of them can be, you know, considered obscene. But at that time, they were more outgoing because they were singing of individual loves. They were not singing of Radha Krishna. And that's very interesting. The Khayal, you know, could say, for example, without referring to Radha and Krishna, we'll say, no, Priyadar Gaya hai. Though it was using the same typology, ki barish aa rahi hai, ye ho raha hai, wo raha hai, but that's because, you know, that connection with life area. So I think there's a delicate balance of forces here, and that's seen very well, that why khayal was popular and why khayal is popular, because it caters to many musical needs than broken. And then perhaps the question is that then, or the question answers itself, that if there is a society which has other musical needs which are fulfilled by Dhrupad, then Dhrupad would find they are there. So when you mention the Western audiences are favoring Dhrupad, very easy to understand that once more they are getting a structured music which is comprehensible, but which is solo music form, which is also melodic music form, which is not collective. The moment you talk of symphony, it's collective music league. So two things are popular in the West, perhaps pop music and Dhrupad. So in a way it's very interesting to see. And Dhrupad fulfills the same needs. In addition, of course, I mean, one knows that what has been said about Dhrupad have a tendency to appeal to modern civilizations, in the sense that they will say this is ancient, going back to. And that creates a kind of nostalgia. I think, you know, nostalgia does not mean that I have to have, you know, relationship, direct relationship with that particular. It's a phase of mind. And I may find, you know, very, very nostalgic when I go to Greece or Rome. Because somewhere along the line, I have passed through mentally those phases of evolution. And I felt, oh, that close democracy, oh, that city-state where I can stand there and ask my questions and people respond. I can be nostalgic about that. Similarly, I think Western audiences are feeling nostalgic about this kind of solo making of music, which is melodic. And of course, compared to Western music, it is tonally, I feel, more cohesive. It lacks tonal color, or, you know, I would say it lacks tonal color. It's a monochrome in a way. But one color presented very solidly. In contrast to what's happening in Western world, this definitely stands a different color. And for us, it's the other way around.
So the coherence is a tremendous appeal.
Tremendous appeal. Something so highly structured, well structured, understandable.
And therefore intelligible.
Therefore
accessible.
Yes, yes. Accessible, yes.
Yes, therefore more accessible.
Yes.
Would it then be right to say, then are we hinting towards the possibility that if Dhrupad is going and undergoing some kind of a revival of popularity in India, it is for the same reasons that the Western mind is accepting it?
That's interesting. I mean, there's some speculation involved there, but yes, I mean, I understand what you are saying, and I feel, you know, in India now, music is now projected. It's not only performed, now projected. Music is projected as a voice of culture, voice of a certain cultural phase, etc., etc. Now, Dhrupad is being projected as ancient, as belonging to the true voice of Indian tradition, etc. And this is appealing to whom? Not to those who are well exposed to, say, Thumris or Khayals or Taranas, but those who are otherwise exposed to other kinds of music, whether it is popular music or Hindi film music or anything. They like this music.
Another way of looking at it, could it be that the freedom of khayal has allowed the quality of musicality and musicianship to decay to such a substantial extent that people feel safer in Dhrupad, that the structure at least guarantees a certain minimum amount of aesthetic coherence?
यू नो व्हाट वी डिड टू ध्रुपद वी आर डूइंग इट टू ख्याना. वी आर कटिंग अवे फ्रॉम ख्याल सम ऑफ हिज एसेट्स. यू नो फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन द 19th सेंचुरी पीपल स्टार्टेड सेइंग इज अ म्यूजिकल आइडिया म्यूजिकल आइडियोलॉजी दैट इन ख्याल म्यूजिक वर्ड्स हैव नो इम्पोर्टेंस. Again, if you look at khayal texts, you see tremendous variety of themes. But look at khayals in circulation. Traditional compositions, very few people sing. New compositions are not significant. They are diluted copies of earlier prototypes.
So what we regarded as insignificant to begin with, to establish khayal, we almost allowed it to go into extinction.
Now, you know, I mean, I will give you some examples. Now, all the, we know that many drupas were transformed into khayals. Now, those drupas were high in poetic quality.
And
how many people, yes, and how many people sing those khayals now? Not many. So that means, you know, that variety has gone. Then from the khayals, which are, you know, I mean, if you analyze even Bhatkhande's, you know, compilation of 1800 compositions in all these six, you will see that there are khayals in Marwadi, Braj, Hindi, Persian, Maithili, Bhojpuri, etc., etc. Now, analyze what people are singing today. Ye bhi variety chali gayi. Ab the Maro Rajendra koi gata hi nahi. The point is that even this variety we have allowed to disappear. Yani language variety gayi. What about taal? Ek taal raha. पहले लोग क्या कहते थे? पहले तिलवाड़े को ख्याल का ठेका ही कहते थे. एसोसिएटेड विथ ख्याल एज अ फॉर्म, बट देन आधा सौ ताल भी था, एक ताल था, रूपक था, वट एवर. बट देर आर मेनी ताल. नाउ दैट हैज गॉन अगेन. और आगे उड़ो. ख्याल में कंपोजर्स थे, वो कंपोजर्स अपने अपने ऑकेजन पे लिखते थे. यानी फॉर देम द क्रिएटिव इम्पल्स वॉज नॉट ओनली बैक्ड बाय म्यूजिक अलोन, इट वॉज ऑल्सो अ लिटररी इम्पल्स, इट वॉज ऑल्सो अ कल्चरल इम्पल्स. वेन दे यूज टू सिंग दैट, ऑब्वियसली एज दे वेर अवेयर ऑफ इट, ये बताने का भी तरीका होता था कि फलाना फलाना कंपोज ने किया है, ऐसा ऐसा ऑकेजन था, ये बताते इसके पीछे एक वाकिया है, ऐसे कह के कुछ. नाउ दैट क्रिएटेड अ परस्पेक्टिव फीज कॉम्पोजिशन एंड द कॉम्पोजिशन एक्वायर अ डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ सिग्निफिकेंस फॉर द लिसनर. अब ये भी बात गायब हो क्योंकि हमको मालूम ही नहीं. अब जाने अकल सब, आई एम ट्राइंग टू अब्यूज अ म्यूजिशियन. मगर बहुत ही डिसेंटली, क्योंकि गा रहा हूं मैं तो गालियां नहीं दे रहा हूं, मैं गाते गाते मैं ये कह रहा हूं ना. अब ये बताया गया तो मजा नहीं आएगा सुनने वालों को, मगर ये अगर मालूम हो तो मैं बताऊं ना. अब देहो देहो सत्संग गुरु श्री रंग बाबा गंग. अब ये बाबा गंग जो आगे होता है वो क्या है, अगर थोड़ा सा भी पता चले. इतने सारे म्यूजिशियन देव देव गाते हैं, अब देहो देहो सत्संग होगा, देव देव सत्संग ये कैसा बनेगा? तो यहां वर्ड्स एंड देयर सैक्रोसैंक्ट लिटररी क्वालिटी वो चली गई. अब पंजाबी हमको नहीं आता, पर्शियन नहीं आता, तो वो भी चला गया. रीजनल वेरिएशन थ्रू उसमें वो चली गई. एंड द कंपोजर्स इंटेंशन क्या है वो देख के मैं गाना मेरा गाना होता था। अब वो ही बात चली गई बिकॉज नाउ आई एम एब्स्ट्रैक्टिंग दैट कंपोजिशन इन सच ए वे दैट इवन द कंपोजर बिकम्स कंपोजर्स इंटेंशन बिकम्स इरेलेवेंट।
He won't be enough for 45 minutes.
45 minutes. एक याद है मुझे बहुत अच्छा किस्सा है। तो बड़ी बड़ी बूंदे बड़ी बड़ी बूंदे अब ये कॉम्पोजिशन था और कुमार जी बात कर रहे थे। कुमार जी कहने लगे अशोक ये कोई ऐसी जगह रहने वाला आदमी होगा कि जिस जहां बारिश कम होती है उसको बड़ा मजा आ गया तो इसने बड़ी एक बार नहीं कहा बड़ी बड़ी बूंद तो वो बड़ी बड़ी अगर इस तरह से वो कहेगा तो गाने में कुछ उसका रिफ्लेक्शन होना चाहिए ना। अब ये जो है तरीका यानी इन अ वे दिस इज नॉट हाई पोएट्री बट इट्स नॉट यू नो मीनिंगलेस रिपीटेशन ऑफ वर्ड नहीं है वो उसमें कुछ पर्पस है। अब ये अगर मैं पकड़ के चलूं तो बात कुछ अलग बन सकती है।
ओके सो वी डिस्ट्रॉयड द लिटरेरी कंटेंट वी ट्रंकेटेड द नंबर ऑफ ताल्स द वैरायटी ऑफ ताल्स विथ द वैरायटी ऑफ ताल्स द लय कंपोनेंट इन ऑफ सिंगिंग ऑल्सो डिकेड बिकॉज द वैरायटी ऑफ ताल्स वॉज लेस द कॉन्शियसनेस ऑफ लय वॉज मच लेस।
और दूसरी एक और एक बात आ गई यानी बिकॉज नाउ यू आर प्रोजेक्टिंग इंडिविजुअल सिंगर एज एन इंडिविजुअल वॉइस बिकेम मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट देन इट वॉज बिफोर। अब वॉइस क्वालिटी अच्छी आफ्टर 40s यू हैड माइक्रोफोन्स तब लोगों को पता चलने लगा आवाज अच्छी है या बुरी है इट स्टार्टेड मेकिंग एन इम्पैक्ट।
किराना वेव वाज डोमिनेटेड बाय द वॉइस क्वालिटी
एंड देन यू विल सी आई मीन यू नो आई डिस्टिंक्टली रिमेम्बर कि बड़े गुलाम अली खान साहब फयाज खान साहब अब्दुल करीम खान साहब वजे बुआ ओमकारनाथ ठाकुर केसर बाई ये छह लोग तो पता चलता है हर एक की वॉइस क्वालिटी कैसी थी यानी none of them were singing like anybody's voices. All of them had distinctive voices of their own. Unique, bilkul. Now, you know, I mean, this is off the record, but Latafat Hussain Khan Sahab, why he couldn't register his own presence? Because he was singing like Fayaz. Kaun sunega? So nobody can become a great musician by singing like somebody or by doing.
The Xerox is not required.
Can't require. So awaaz became important, extremely important, and if day by day it's acquiring more importance. And you know, to put it still more further, the case is that any voice has three dimensions: pitch, volume, and timbre. Timber is a dimension for the coming century, not pitch and volume.
So what you are saying is, volume as it is no longer important because of amplification electronics, and pitch will take a beating.
And even pitch is not important. क्योंकि you know पहले pitch क्यों अच्छा लगता था ऊंचा pitch. One is of course carrying power, and secondly brightness. In upper pitch has more partials, which are brighter partials. Lower pitch is denser, it is richer, but reach kam hai uski. Now if I can use a microphone, I can afford to have a low pitch, because my richness will be conveyed to people, communicated to people.
And also today pitch can be electronically manipulated.
Right. Yes, so ab you know, the problem is now, there is still further interesting point yahan hai ki, Now, singers, I mean, ख्याल की तो चर्चा यही चल रही है मगर now, as singers are becoming more and more conscious of voice as a contributory factor towards exciting satisfaction derived from music, they have been compelled to do that not only by recording equipment but also by the instrumental music quality that we have given. If sitar and sarangi and din and sarod and violin, they are giving me timbres which were unheard of before. I am competing with those timbres now. So unless my music is full of nuances, where can I stand?
Okay, so in this context, what you are saying is Drupad is a safer haven for a lot of people who are not particularly initiated. Pre-packaged, accessible music.
Yes, we were at that popularity, yes. These are the main points there. And now three things to be mentioned. Not very major, but minor contributory factors. Associated instruments. हमेशा ये बताया गया कि ध्रुपद के साथ दीन बजता, सारंगी नहीं बजती. वाय? क्योंकि सारंगी बजती थी डांस के साथ. अदरवाइज फॉर म्यूजिकल क्वालिटी, वाय? आई मीन, वाई डू यू नीड टू हैव बीन इफ यू हैड अ सारंगी? बिकॉज यू कुडंट टेक सारंगी. And reasons may not be, and we are not obviously musical reasons. Yes, a pakhawat hai, so yes, but the moment you take tabla, you know, there are gaps created. Pakhawat ki sonority ye hai ki one syllable blurs into the other.
There is no porosity.
Ab tabla mein ye nahi hai.
Porosity.
The moment aap dhin kaha, to dhin khatam ho gaya, to mujhe bharni hai wo jagah. So, you know, all these instruments which are associated with Drupad, like Pakhawaj and perhaps Deen also, I mean, is, you know, it's very obvious that Deen may be a blurring quality. In a ek sur baja, dusra baja, it
gives
sustain. So, you know, shadow hai iski. Wo shadow bahut pyari lagti hai. Ab wo shadow nahi milti hai mujhe. Mere saath Drupad mein kya hota hai abhi? Kya hota hai aaj?
सारंगी
प्लेयर रहता है. तो सारंगी इज मोर कंटिन्यूस देन माय वॉइस दे, और मैं रिदम पे काम कर रहा हूं. टू डजन टैली. एंड पखावज की बात हुई, एज आई सेड, पखावज बाय इट्सेल्फ, आई मीन, इट्स वेरी अनफॉर्चुनेट दैट पखावज का रिचनेस जो है, इट इज नॉट बीइंग यूज्ड प्रॉपरली. I feel timber-wise, language-wise, Pakhawaj is extremely rich. But tabla is doing what Khyal has done to Drupad. That tabla has taken over things of Pakhawaj. And it is packaged in well with additional attractions like timber, high pitch, clarity, pace, everything. But Pakhawaj has a rich language. So somewhere, somebody will come and say, no, I am going to make music where Pakhawaj is again to the fore. But Drupad losing its battle because Pakhawaj is a certain kind of instrument and it requires a certain kind of scope for expression. It's not getting there. So the associated instruments now are also important. And if you associate other instruments, you'll have to change the Drupad itself.
Yes.
So you know, that stands to reason that साथ में डूबेंगे साथ में तरेंगे, ऐसी बात होगी वो. एंड देन आई थिंक लास्टली एकोस्टिक स्पेस की बात कही, तो यस, आई मीन, अनलेस यू गेट वेरी वेल डिजाइन एकोस्टिक प्लेसेस एंड यू नो केयर टू यूज द पब्लिक एड्रेस सिस्टम प्रॉपरली. अब जो पखावज बजेगा ध्रुपद के साथ, इट कन्फ्यूजेस यू मोर बिकॉज द कॉन्टूर्स आर नॉट क्लियर. While you are using all the time tabla which is high pitch, अब सुर का तबला लेके कोई गाता भी नहीं. सुर के तबले की क्वालिटी बिल्कुल पखावज की ही क्वालिटी होती है. तो क्लैरिटी मिलती है हाई पिच में, तो पीपल आर टेकिंग दैट. तो यू नो द एकोस्टिक स्पेस इन विच वी आर परफॉर्मिंग टूडे एक्चुअली इज कंड्यूसिव टू सम काइंड ऑफ रिकम्पोज म्यूजिक. And quality of sound which is distinctive and can be fed in and faded out. So in a way, it's not surprising that even Khyal is now becoming pre-composed. 10 baar logon ko sune, उसको ये लगता है कि हाँ इसके बाद तो ये ही गाएंगे, ऐसी ही तान आएगी, क्योंकि नाउ ही हैज इन अ वे डिजाइन ही म्यूजिक टू सूट अ पर्टिकुलर काइंड ऑफ स्पेस। आजकल तो गाना बजाना होता है तो कंट्रोल्ड स्पेसिस में ही होता है। पहले क्या होता था, चेंबर कॉन्सर्ट भी होता था, घर में भी बैठ के गाते थे, बरसी में भी गाते थे, ओपन एयर में भी गाते थे, सभी जगह गाते थे। अब दैट इज बिकमिंग मोर कंट्रोल्ड।
एक्चुअली द ग्रोइंग इफ देयर इज अ रिवाइवल ऑफ सम काइंड ऑफ रिवाइवल ऑफ ड्रुपद पॉपुलैरिटी, व्हाट यू सेइंग इज इट्स नॉट वेरी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम व्हाट ख्याल हैज बीन टेंडिंग टू बिकम एनीवे।
आई व्यू दिस एज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग फैसिनेटिंग इंटरप्ले ऑफ फोर्सेस। I am also getting the feeling that, as I said earlier, that no performing genre dies out. It assumes another garb and changes the category. मुझे ये लगता है कि अब पहले जैसे भजन होते थे, वो भजन में लोग right from cinema songs everything they used to take it. Now I feel that, you know, bhajans are more controlled. Bhajans are becoming pre-composed music, highly pre-composed. So perhaps, you know, more dhrupad tendencies will enter there. Kyunki unke liye bhi ek to divine sanction or sacred themes aur ye sab hai. Ab uske saath mujhe control chahiye sab, environment chahiye. And I'm adding things. अब जो एडिशन करनी है वो किसकी करनी है, सो थिंग विच विल कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टू द जनरल इफेक्ट विच आई वॉन्ट टू क्रिएट। माई जनरल इफेक्ट इज नाउ माई इंटेंशन टू क्रिएट दैट ठीक चाहिए। और एक बार जो हम देख रहे हैं कि कलेक्टिविटी आ रही है म्यूजिक में ज्यादा, एंड आई एम नॉट सेइंग ओनली ऑफ एज आई सेड आर्ट म्यूजिक, इन द टोटल सीन। अब टीवी पे देखो तो सबसे ज्यादा गाने क्या होते हैं, तो डांस के साथ होते हैं। सबसे ज्यादा डांस काय के होते तो होल गैंग इज डांसिंग। तो 16 एलिमेंट क्या है, मर्जिंग हो रहा है, इंडिविजुअल्स के लिए नहीं है वहां को, क्राउड के लिए है। व्हाई दिस सडन क्रेज फॉर यू नो हैव कम्युनिटी सॉन्ग्स, क्योंकि वी गेट अ फीलिंग दैट नो आवर एज अ सोसाइटी we are lacking in one genre where people can come together and sing something in common. Kyunki religion ka gaya to aarti vagera chali gayi, daily rituals mein tha wo bhi chala gaya, patriotic songs vagera wo bhi chale gaye, kyunki ab national movement to nahi rahi, kuch independence hai, anti british struggle hai, sab ho kare kya, saath mein gaane ke liye hai kya? Popular genre pehle folk mein thi, वो गई है, बिकॉज नाउ वी आर हाईली अर्बनाइज सोसाइटीज एवरीवेयर, टू करे क्या, सो वी आर क्रिएटिंग नाउ एंड दैट इज कमिंग इन पॉपुलर म्यूजिक,
एंड देयरफॉर इफ दैट मस्ट मूव टुवर्ड्स मोर एंड मोर प्री कंपोज्ड,
यस,
बिकॉज दैट इज द ओनली वे टू शेयर इट, एंड इट हैज टू मूव टुवर्ड्स द लोएस्ट कॉमन डिनोमिनेटर,
यस, अंडरस्टैंडेबल म्यूजिक,
यस, इजीली, क्वाइट, आइदर इन टर्म्स ऑफ इंटेलेक्ट और इनिशिएशन।
सारे भजन भारत में, सारा रिलीजियस म्यूजिक देखो, चार और आठ में ही कंपोज किया हुआ क्यों है, बिकॉज इट्स मेंट फॉर मासेस। एनी बडी विदाउट हैविंग एनी ट्रेनिंग मस्ट बी एबल टू ज्वाइन इन, दैट्स द टेस्ट।
सो देन व्हाट यू आर सेइंग इज ऑन अ ब्रॉडर कैनवस वी कैन ऑल्सो से दैट द नॉर्थ एंड साउथ डिवाइड इज ऑल्सो प्रोबेबली नैरोइंग बिकॉज ऑफ दैट।
Yes. That very interesting that the first Baroda Conference 1916, you see the manifesto, no less a person than Pandit Bhatkhande saying that we will try to evolve a national music of India